Hey guys, and welcome back to Amelia Kate Productions. So, I just finished reading, well, listening in this case, to The Eyes of Tamurah, which is a book by Marie V. Snyder. And had it not been by Marie V. Snyder, I probably would have never touched it, because the only thing I knew about it was that it had archaeology in it, and I'm not that fond of archaeology. And so, I was excited about a new Marie V. Snyder book, and that's all I cared about because she's my favourite author. So it's just like, I will listen to anything, read anything she writes because, yeah, I listen to things mostly because dyslexic and it's easier. Anyway, so I just finished listening to The Eyes of Tamurah by Marie V. Snyder, and it is so good. So it is about, oh yeah, spoilers in case. There are probably spoilers. I don't know how to be a spoiler detective myself, so there's probably spoilers. Anyway, so The Eyes of Tamurah is about a girl called Jyla, and she's what they call sun-kissed, which means she has very fair blonde hair, and what usually happens is the sun-kissed babies are usually taken above ground because they live in this like underground city, because the sun is so harsh outside that at certain times of the day it'll literally boil your blood and cook you alive in a matter of seconds or even minutes. And just like, whoa. So they can only go above ground at certain times, so they live entirely underground. Anyway, so only like a couple creatures can survive in those elements, like things like the Velblast, which is like a creature that flies around and stuff. So, usually what happened with sun-kissed babies is they were sacrificed to the sun goddess, which is like their being, like their god. So Jyla was saved from being like sacrificed by the, oh, I can't remember what their full name is, but they're monks, and they live like in their own separate compound, and they go against like the goddess's rule of like sacrificing the sun-kissed babies, and they rescue as many as they can, like they rescue them if they run into them, like as they go on their treks through the sanded, like there, as they go on their treks above ground, they will like save the sun-kissed if they find them being like sacrificed out there. So Jyla like moves away from the monks, and when we meet her, she is someone who's sort of like, she uses maps and stuff to uncover the locations of like where priceless artifacts are, and then she sends this information to an archaeologist who then pays her for information, and they do the dig site, they find the thing. So her last job was on this thing called the Eyes of Tamurah, and she found the resting place of these eyes, gave the information to her friend Banqui, who paid her, and he was finding the eyes for what they call the Water Prince. And he's like in charge of everything because he controls the water source, and like, if you control the water source, you are the Water Prince. So soon after the eyes are uncovered, they go missing, somebody's stolen them. And Banqui and Jyla are like the only ones that know anything about the location of these eyes and stuff, like everybody else is like kept in darkness. So the Water Prince is like really ticked off, and he imprisons Banqui, and Banqui is Shyla's only friend because he's the only one that hasn't like been prejudiced about her hair colour and the fact that she's sun-kissed. So the only friend she has is just being taken by the Water Prince, and she has also been taken by the Water Prince, and she's like, it's just assumed that she's stolen the eyes. And so the Water Prince is all like, where have you taken the eyes? And she's like, I don't have the eyes, I don't know where they are. And so he employs her to find the eyes in exchange for Banqui's life. So now she has to go all undercover and search through all the city to try and find information on who stole these eyes and where they could be. And then like the Heligal Priestess, which is like the sun goddess's like main a worshipper sort of person. She like runs half the city and she finds out about this. And she also wants the eyes. So she's like sending all her deacons out to like, she sends her deacons out to like capture Shiloh and take her back. And then she's like, where are the eyes? And then Shiloh's like, I don't have the eyes. And she's like, I don't believe you. Give her the holy water. And like Shiloh like spills her guts like about not knowing where they are. About her deal with the water prince to find the eyes, and then she'll save Binkley's life. So now the Helical priestess is like, well, if you're the only one who can find these eyes, if you find me these eyes, I can use them to save your friend, and I'm the better person to give these eyes to. So when you find these eyes, you give them to me. So it starts this whole little rat race thing of like, who's gonna get the eyes first, who's she gonna give them to, and everything. I'm not gonna say anymore, because I want you guys to read it, and it's so freaking amazing. I read it, I listened to it for so long. I listened to it nearly all day, and then I think I had about an hour to go, and it was 4 in the morning, and I was just like glued, my eyes glued to the phone, just like listening. Couldn't do anything else, was just like, what's gonna happen next? And I had about an hour to go, and I fell asleep. And I woke up and I was just like, no, how could I fall asleep? Where was I up to? Because this book had finished. And I was just like, where am I up to? So I finished it, figured out where I was up to. And it's been like, oh, it was so, so good. I haven't stayed up all night listening to a book in a long time. But, anyway, so I highly, 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 highly recommend this book. And I think the only place you can get it at the moment is in Australia, which is kind of ironic because usually Australia is the last place to get anything, and usually you can't, like, usually when I want a book it's just like, oh, this isn't out in Australia yet, but this time it's only out in Australia. I think she's still looking for a publisher in America, but it was so good, and I loved it. And I didn't think I would love it as much as I did. Like, I knew I already loved Poison Study, and like, I loved the Glass series, but like, I didn't think there would be any sort of magic in there, and like, a little bit of a spoiler, there's like some magic in there, and like, it kept your brain thinking the whole entire time, and it's like, ooh, what's this puzzle, and what's this puzzle? Like, you're trying to figure out what's going on the whole time. And I really loved it. I highly recommend, if you live in Australia, buy the book. Buy it right now. It's so good. Or if you don't live in Australia, I think that you can go through some companies and they ship to other countries the Australian edition. I think Dymex does. Don't hold me to that, it's just a thing. But I'm pretty sure Dymex ships it to like a few other countries, but it was such a good book, and I loved it so much, and I've never, like, done a video on a book that I liked before, so, yeah. It was so, so, so good, and I love it so much, and Tamurah Snyder is an amazing author, and just everybody should read all of her books, and right now I'm waiting for, her sequel to Navigating the Stars come out, because that is another book that I was kind of, like, iffy on to begin with. Like, oh, it's sci-fi, I'm not sure if I'll like enjoy it. I loved it. I loved it so much. So go read it.